Hello folks. I think almost a year has passed since my last video, and I guess that's a new record actually. And as you might imagine, I've been a little bit busy. So this time right here, I guess it's busy everywhere in the world. The world is recovering from the COVID situation, and everything's going crazy. Material prices are sky high, and it's actually even difficult to get material sometimes, no matter the price. And also, so many orders are coming in from everywhere. Everybody wants parts. So it's crazy all around. But as I said, a year has passed and a lot has changed as well. So we are still here in the same spot, and we are basically doing the same thing that we used to do, but I think the company has never changed as much as it has this year. So you may recall, a few years ago I started in my basement working alone with manual machines and the Fadal 3016, and now I think I have 10 people in my list in working for me, and that's just amazing. It's an amazing feeling to be able to offer a living to so many people. It still isn't easy. It's actually crazy tough and hard, and it really hasn't gotten any easier. I guess I'm just more used to being stressed all the time, but of course I also have a very good team working with me right now, and I have some back support that I haven't had before. So, but basically I'm still responsible for everything, like I have always been so far, and it is terrifying, but it's also very satisfying. Okay, enough talk about that. So everybody's interested what has happened, and I guess the major difference actually has been in the kind of work that we do. When I started this company, and when we were just like 2 or 3 people working, we were actually pretty much only working on special stuff. One-offs and prototyping and stuff like that, but we have almost moved off from that right now, and I guess that's what happens to most shops. They start with small stuff and short batches, and they move towards mass producing parts, and we have moved towards making masses of simple parts, and that's just because it's as it's difficult to find material, it's also almost impossible to find talented people to work. So right now it's just pretty much 3 of us who are able to use all the machines and do all the programming and set up work and stuff like that, and the rest of the folks just keep the machines running. So I guess it's better to just use the more skillful folks to set up work, and then have the other people run 2 to 3 machines at once, compared to one really skilled guy working on just one machine at a time making special parts. I guess that's just a natural progression that every machining company takes. And it's kind of sad, because making those special parts is really fun and really challenging. And yes, we still do that, but just so much less than we used to. But also the space has changed a little bit. This space right here, where our material storage is, we didn't have this space at the start of the year. I guess our space started from this wall right here. So now we have quite a bit of more space. And it is a mess in here, and we still have pretty much a pretty bad mess all over the shop. It's just too busy all the time, and me and the other most skilled guys are just too busy working on machines rather than making improvements to the shop itself, which is really sad, but it's just impossible to find time for that right now. And also we have a guy who's actually a great friend of mine, who's mostly working here, working on the saw, on the bandsaw, making pieces to machine on the machines. And his job is also to keep the shop tidy. But he's been off quite a bit lately. I guess I can say to you that he's actually having his first child at about the end of this year, and that's the reason for him not being around very much lately. But that also shows here, it's a mess. So anyway, we have some stock here, we have some bar stock sawed and ready to go to the machines. And then we have some scrap parts and some leftover parts from some orders. And yeah, not so much has changed here. Well, everything has changed because we haven't had this space before. But I mean, not so much going on in here. And how this is supposed to work, the material comes in on the floor, and right away we move it to the saw and either cut it in half and move it to this shelf, or preferably we saw it and chop it up to the correct length pieces, and they go either to this shelf right here or they go straight to the machine. So we try to store as little stuff on the floor as possible, but as you can see, it really hasn't worked too well, actually. So we have quite a bit of steel in here. I guess these two pallets weigh like 2,000 kilograms or something like that. And we have a little coffee room in here. It's actually quite a bit too small for us, but because of the COVID, we have been trying to keep some distance, of course, and not having many people sit at the same table at the same time. So 4 seats is actually okay. And we have this little board which we have a question of the day. For example, right now it's reading the best thing about winter, and it says all kinds of funny answers. And actually the most popular answer is when the winter ends. That's the best thing about winter. So, and also what I forgot to mention, that we also work in two shifts, and it's actually Friday evening right now, and today we don't have a night shift because we have some people off. So we usually work from 7:30 to 11 p.m. So we try to keep the machines running as much as possible. And right now we actually have all the machines running except for the Mitsui Seiki, which has been giving us quite a bit of trouble lately. It has some axis amplifier faults. We are trying to get that sorted. But every single other machine is running. Even the old Dali is making some sprockets, milling the tooth profile. And the Quasar is doing some kind of work. And right here we have the Takisawa lathe, which is making these larger pieces of steel from these. And it has been working really well. Looks like the chip conveyor is stuck, but apart from that. And if David Wilkes is watching, we are still running your trepanning tool. It has gotten quite a bit worn actually, because we have made, like, as you can see, we have these slugs everywhere, and this is not nearly all of them. I don't even know how many cuts it has made. I think 1,000 cuts is an underestimate. So 1,000 pieces of these. I actually have a video about turning one of these on this lathe, if you search my older videos. So trepanning is really a good method for making large holes. And then we have some stuff going on the Akira Seiki machine. And then we have some turn parts for the Femco lathe. And what else? Right now we are in the process of moving this shelf to somewhere in here. So all the machines are working hard. Some horrible mess on the table. And you may recall we have a fourth axis on this Akira Seiki, and we try to utilize it quite a bit, and it is often very useful. And what else? Well, the Dusan Puma, we have had some misfortune with it once again. It actually has bad spindle bearings now, and that's completely our fault. We crashed the machine pretty badly, and one of the frontside bearings is making a nasty sound right now. Actually, it's been like half a year doing that, and the sound hasn't changed, and I even have the new bearings, but I really haven't just found enough downtime to do the fix. But I guess it will have to be done until the end of this year. Other than that, the Puma has been pretty good. It has some things that I don't like about it, but I guess the base machine itself is really good and solid and accurate and strong. And of course, we still have my old Padal 3016, which we still use every single day, and it's making parts every single day. It has actually developed an issue, probably with the spindle motor. At the moment, it's not rotating, spinning more than 4200 RPM. It first stopped at like 6,500, and now it's only 4.2. I think we have to replace the spindle motor. And also we have this another Fadal right now. I have actually no idea if I even showed this to you before. Probably not actually. So I guess this is actually our newest machine. So it's a Fadal 3020. And this is a performance model. So it is supposed to have quick rapids, and it has box ways in all axes, and I guess a 30 pocket arm tool changer and 10,000 RPM spindle and true spindle coolant and all kinds of stuff. I guess we have been kind of unlucky with this machine. It has been down quite a bit, and actually we have kept this machine on for like 1 month straight now, because it's a pain in the ass to get started. It likes to give some kind of an error on z-axis, I think, but as long as you keep the machine on and never shut it off, it works. And also we have been having lots of trouble on the high and low gear thing, and it's actually missing the seat metal right now. So you have two belts in here, and you have this pneumatic actuarial system which kind of slacks the other belt and tightens the other, and we have been spending a lot of resources on getting it to work properly, but after all we ended up just taking out the low speed belt completely. And also we are not running the true spindle coolant because there's some kind of a coolant leak. We have had all of this apart, and I guess we just have to do it again and investigate where it's leaking. But it has still been making very much parts, and it's now running every single day. And actually right now, I guess I can show this to you, we are making these kind of parts. You may know, behind this wall we have a huge company which makes sheet metal parts, and we are cooperating with them. We get these sheet metal parts and we do friction drilling and form tapping on these parts, and we have lots of these to make. So this is a project of a worker of mine, and then we see the manual area. We have the surface grinder and the Ryazan 1M63 lathe, and the little IZH lathe, and the long large TOS lathe. So that's our manual machines. I think this year I actually sold the universal milling machine. We just didn't have use for it, and it was kind of a little bit worn and not completely functional, so I just decided to get rid of it. But to replace it, we actually got this gem, which is an original Bridgeport. And this actually also came from a school, and it's in really good condition. The ways are almost perfect. As you can see, there's some beautiful flaking and pretty much nowhere at all. So it's beautiful. And we also use it at least weekly to do simple work and like drilling and threading and stuff like that. And when we continue here, we actually have a checking point in here. Everything that we finish, we stop. We carry here and stop. Right here it says checkpoint or a quality checkpoint. And nothing is sent out before it's been quality checked. So we have quite a bit of stuff here. Maybe somebody would actually need to check this. And probably me, actually. So, and we also have one more addition, which is still a little bit in progress. We have this Mazak Quick Turn 15. I think it's a 98 model, and I got this basically for scrap price, and it had a board fault, and that actually got fixed already. but we are actually waiting for a Mazak service guy to try to get the machine running again. It's missing all the parameters. We actually managed to feed them in, but there's still some things wrong which we have to fix, and I have never run this control myself, so we actually also need some help to run it. So just waiting for the service guy to appear, and looks like it's actually really, really dirty inside for some reason. Probably has been leaking coolant somewhere. But this machine is still in progress, but we really need another lathe. And what's also new is that we have ordered our second completely new machine after the Dusan Puma. We have placed an order on VF6 SS Haas, and it should arrive on January next year. So that's really exciting. So it's a VF6 XS, so it's a pretty large VMC. It's got a 15,000 RPM spindle and probing systems and whatnot. It's a pretty cool machine, I think. And I think when we get that machine, this machine and that Haas will be the first machines to find their place right here. So you might or might not remember, but this whole corridor is actually reserved for us. So whenever we need space in this direction, we can get it. So I guess this is the first time that we actually need the space right here. So we will be expanding here. So I guess that's most of what's happened. So everything is growing. Everything is growing. We still don't have... the company is not extremely profitable. I guess I have been focusing on growing a little bit too much over keeping the company profitable. But we are still doing okay, and we are growing really fast. So I actually, at the moment at least, I enjoy growing the company more than earning a lot of money from it. So maybe the earning part will come someday, but so far I'm just focused on growing this company. And for the start of next year, we also have some new customers and some really interesting stuff coming. And I'm hoping next year we will invest in our third new machine, which will be a mill turn machine. I mean, probably something like the Puma. Maybe not another Puma. The Puma is actually a little bit too large for us. We don't need a machine this big. A Lynx, for example, would be good. But actually, I don't think I will go with a Dusan anymore. A Morris Eiki, for example, would be a nice option, or even Haas. But we will see. We will see. But we really need another machine, another lathe with milling tools, with milling capacity, because this right now is our only lathe with milling tools as well. So I guess I just wanted to give you an update. I really don't even recall when was the last time that I that I read my comments on my videos. I guess after this video I really should do a recap on what you have commented on my videos. I still like making videos, but it's just gotten really, really difficult because we have the night shift working and it's never quiet and peaceful in here except for right now. So it's really not a good environment for filming anymore. But whenever I have the chance and I feel like it, I will post a video. And at least you now know that I'm still here and I'm alive and I'm doing good. And I hope you are too. And I hope wherever you are, things are going good or getting at least better all the time. So I guess I don't have much more to say right now. I cannot promise you the next video schedule, but I will make a video again, that's for sure. So thanks to everybody for sticking around for so long, and I really look forward to read your comments on this video and to hear how things are going around the world. So thanks so much for watching, and we will see you again. Bye.